Located deep within the Ladakh valley of Zanskar, the Phukthar Monastery is built around a cave perched on a hill high above the Sarabchu River. It is an ancient monastery with a remarkable community of monks and novices living at one with nature in a remote valley in the harshest of environments. Cut off from the modern world, without any roads or even a telephone connection, life in Phukthar has continued pretty much in the same way as it had for centuries. The monastery is like a frozen repository of time, offering a rare glimpse at an old way of life without the distractions of the modern world. The monks have very little to call their own, but yet everything they have is generously shared with others. They have a childlike enthusiasm for seeing the world around them, making light of even their hardest chores by turning it into something playful. Life here in Phukthar is slow, but it is also full of joy and has valuable lessons for the rest of us living our lives in the fast-paced materialistic world. In this series, we will take a deeper look at the life in the monastery and try to tell the untold story of Phukthar. The origin of Phukthar dates back as far as 2500 years ago. One of the 16 Arhats, the original disciples of Lord Buddha, is said to have lived here in the cave, teaching over 3000 disciples.
Phukthar jante ula I ye Phukthar sirf ye kya bhe ke bau sirf bau de yoga de bau de titula phaba tilden jan phapte I sirf bau bau ne kule chuje yoga de tu teni chang I khang ba dan chin chang kang me ga de teni phala china lo ni thong cha no de.
Many such mystics have meditated in the cave over the centuries, and some may be even getting enlightened in the process. This is how the cave came to be known as Phukthar, the cave of liberation.
Tarong phin sum I ka du ju de lo mang pu ji ju ha zar du teni khom bang ya la sha tang ji dan yang go ba du ma chang ye pha chang me ga de teni ko mi sum I ka du te che ju de teni de go be na la che ju de teni khom ba sama phur song ga za shi de du de ji ne wo de ni phala Phukthar jan de du to ha zar Phukthar gi phuk be na ni mi sama
While the cave has attracted mystics for over 2000 years, the monastery in its present form took shape around 600 years back when a master named Changsam Sherab Zampo introduced the Gelugpa order of Buddhism to Phukthar.
Changsam Sherab Zampo pepte odeni phela ta gizul dang gelong dang tisu sonde ikani utu gizul dang gelong jisum me domba de jisum zende odeni phela su hazat putan te dini phela taba halam jipju ngapju tuju dinju yeju yasu balang mang bu ikha chungwa de.
The monastery is built vertically on a cliffside with the monks' quarters, the tashaks, stacked on top of each other like carts. The construction is ancient and the entire monastery is built using wood, stone and mud. The heart of the monastery is of course the cave, and it has a big stupa dedicated to Changsam Sherab Zangpo, the founder of the monastery. There is a small courtyard below the stupa where the monks sit in the open to do their pujas, eat, drink, study, etc. One curious result of the vertical construction is that the monastery just doesn't have any space for conducting the mask dances. In fact, Phukthar is the only big monastery of its kind that does not perform any mask dances during its festivals. Another interesting feature of the monastery is the lone juniper tree perched on top of the cave. It is located right above the stupa inside the cave, and this is the reason why the monks have named the tree as Changsam Uduks, meaning the umbrella of Changsam.
Sida upa ye ye tubai tubai ke chordan chordan go sida du bolta hai budu jisna ki tasmo ji Changsam Udu zend Changsam shira zend Udu zend no zend Changsam ko sida Changsam me thaso ingo shubai go zend te zab Changsam me du no zend tasam Changsam Udu no zend o to ma khechen du zend mimang pe zend Changsam Udu no zend shupa.
Locally known as Shupa, the juniper tree is highly regarded in the Buddhist Himalayam. Their needle-like leaves give off a very pleasant aroma when burnt, and the smoke is used in various rituals. And the juniper wood is highly prized for use in construction, as it is very strong and does not rot over time. In fact, all the pillars holding up the Phukthar Monastery against the cliff face are made from juniper trees. Situated right opposite the monastery, across the Sarapchu River, is the village of Yugar. The village is home to three big juniper trees of its own, and the locals believe that the four trees, the one in Phukthar and the three in Yugar, somehow have their roots connected to each other.
Khachi ki zardu te ee phuta la ee shupa dang yor shupa on til ni sadil ni zo phada hyang de go zar ta te zar shila me go hyang de yoga da hen thong ni me ga te zana ee phuta le de ku chance me udu no zar yor ye yo gende ne sarda yamo zan da te hang shu yor ta chi yor ne chon ro mo no zan te chi hang de ne jo shin de no zar yor la sum me go te sum ga chi ta mi sa me zar del de go chi go mi na pati ni zo pata hyang de yor la son no yor ni wa yo de no zar ti zo ma ham no lo kan chi tham ni go pu dang go ba cha ba ni pa la yi pu dang go be ge yi shu ba tum go rang ma ha ma no zu jin no.
Apart from Yugar, the Phukthar Monastery services around 20 villages in the area, starting from the Ichar village downstream and going all the way up to Kargyak, which is the last village in the Lungnak Valley.
Total da iputang gobeng ayola mang puyo ka halam joan 20 ya 20 ni shu jongjen gonpani chon kubi gi chon da kubi gi madat chon nga ja ichar je sani yang kubi nekal ni shu dan jen kubi bete dal tomba ye gu para la te dine se sane dan jen mali ni dan jen ne ten da yu ne kyon jen kubi made no te dine dang ji gi sa ge be san sa ge de tal su ne zo kubi pem bete kyon da made su no pem bete kyon dan.
The villagers also contribute to the monastery by sending their kids to be trained as monks. Although this practice is slowly declining, the monks are not worried and are confident about this tradition continuing into the future as well.
Lama sama kubarang thaid chono da lama zain de ko ngulmani kibu duze ngaji da tham su ba ngaji de cheba dang ji dang ngujmen ko chona jo ma jo ma jo ngu ji lang ji ge da sam mi da ba ni shu sum ju ji te sama kubara ba ma na za de kubi chue de no ya ngaji thal za yong jmen mula ngun jmen da sama thal za ma zu pa shanti su ju cheba dang ju thal ju ma jo na ju ji te ju cheba ngun jmen ta thangman ni da ba mula da ba thu duru nga duru puja yo gesa te ne re ni ju da sama ji yul sama ni sum ju sama ni ju sum ju ju de.
So this is how the Phukthar Monastery came into existence and managed to flourish over the centuries. In the next episode, we will see what a typical day is like at the monastery from sunrise till sunset and try to understand and appreciate the challenges of monastic life at the Phukthar Monastery.